Chirag, you can go ahead. Thank you.
Yeah. Thanks, Pranamesh. Hello, everyone. A very good evening. Thanks for your time today. Now, as we all know, today's topic is about digital marketing. So without further ado, I will start with the topic. So just give me a second. I'll quickly share my presentation.
Chirag, yeah? Your audible voice is not bit audible. So if you can speak louder.
Is it better now?
Yes. Go ahead.
Great, great. So let me just share the screen. So Pranamesh, is this PPT there on the screen now? Can everyone see that?
Yes.
Great. So today's session will be more about digital marketing in general. So as we all know, digital marketing is a vast area. So to cover the entire thing in 30 minutes would be very difficult. So what I've done is I'm focusing on a couple of basics that people should take into consideration while devising their digital marketing strategy, because that will help you to build a very strong foundation. Okay. Now, before I dive in deeper into the subject, let me start with a story like we did yesterday. So there was this king who was on a path, and he was going, and he suddenly came across a sage. He asked the sage, where does this road lead to? The sage tells him, where do you want to go? So the king just answers casually, saying, nowhere, I'm just exploring things. So the sage then responds back to the king, saying, then how does it matter, take any road. So this is normally how people consider their digital marketing strategy to be. Many of them do not have a definite roadmap. They know that there is a certain destination that they have to reach to. They know that they are looking at creating brand awareness. They know that they want to generate business from digital marketing, but there is not a definite roadmap on how to go ahead with that. So that is where we'll be looking at on this presentation today, as to how to build those foundations such that on that foundation, you will be able to build a stronger relationships with everyone. Now, for you to go from nowhere to now here, you'll need a map. So mapping is the key, planning is the key. Okay. Now, I'm sure that everyone knows that, getting to interact better with the customer or your target audience is the key when it comes to digital marketing. Now, the question out there is, how many of us are aware about our target audience? How do we know our target audience, or how well do we know them? Okay, the first step in the journey is about the buyer or the target audience. So we'll look at buyer persona in general. Now, these might seem to be very simple questions, like who is your target audience? What problems do you help them solve? What are the desired actions that you want them to take, etc.? But have we put all the answers to these questions in a place where we can have them ready to look at any point of given time that we want? It becomes very, we all know our business really well. We know that customers are important, but knowing that customer is also equally important. Everyone has a vague idea in their mindsets, but I'm not sure how many of you document these answers and keep on reviewing them periodically, right? So now let's look at a good way of keeping a track of these questions and answering them. So I'm sharing a Excel sheet, which I've prepared as a demo for everyone to have a look at. Let me know once you can see the Excel sheet. Pranavish, can you see the sheet?
Yes.
On the right. So now I've created a very, this is a part of the entire template that I use for my buyer persona. So this is a small snippet from that. So the first question, who is the target audience? So when I look at it from my digital marketing business, individuals like solopreneurs, bloggers, influencers, business consultants, trainers, coach, etc. could be one section. Another section could be of sales and marketing professionals. One more section could be entrepreneurs, startup co-founders, or any businesses that are there. And the next one could be a student. Okay. Now, what are the problems that I'm solving for them? Okay. Now, when I look at the first section, which is the individuals part of it, I'm considering a corporate trainer in this case. Now, the main objective of a corporate trainer would be he or she would be interested in conducting training seminars across India, create a healthy sales funnel, create an online brand presence, to be considered as an authority in their respective field. They may have
Chirag, you are freezed as of now.
Pardon me?
You're freezed as of now.
Yeah, so I'm not moving anything. Can you now?
Yes, go ahead. Now you can go ahead.
Yeah. And lead generation would be another aspect. Similarly, each buyer persona which would be there would have different problems that they are looking to solve. Okay, so let's say if I'm looking from a sales and marketing professional, they want to switch careers, or if you are a hardcore sales person, you want to generate leads from your online digital marketing campaigns, or you're just looking as a personal brand building exercise, right? Now, once you know what problems you are solving for your customers, you should also work on what are the desired action steps that you want them to take. Now, some of them could be purchase. For me, it could be purchasing my digital marketing services, purchasing my training modules, following me on social media for latest updates, joining my email list, downloading any e-books. So I've put them in different buckets depending upon what is applicable based on each buyer persona. Now the next question is, why should they buy from me? What is my USP? What are my credentials? What is my credibility? Are there any testimonials or references that they can look into? Again, those are bifurcated in section wise based on the buyer persona. Next thing is, where will I find these buyers? So if I strictly stick to the online medium, these could be my website, an email campaign, online surveys, any free giveaway or free webinar like what we are conducting right now, a WhatsApp campaign or a Facebook, LinkedIn, Twitter, paid advertising campaigns, campaigns on other platforms, any references, etc., etc. Now this entire template which is there will depend on the kind of business that you have and the business model that you employ. So this I've given you a snapshot of how you can know more about your target audience, and always keep this ready with you when you are planning your digital marketing. In fact, this is something that will be helpful for you from your business as well as your normal marketing as well, right? So now let me move on back to the PPT which is there. Yeah, so we covered these questions. Now, the next thing that we're looking at, we all have heard this adage a long time back, customer is the king, is always and will always remain that. But there are few more people who are as important, or I would say more important than the king. That is the content. Content is the king maker in my opinion. And when there is a king, the queen cannot be behind. So the customer engagement or your engagement with your target audience is your queen. Now, how these three are interrelated to each other and what are the roles that exactly plays is what we are going to look at. Okay. Now, where will you find the kingmaker? Right. The thing is, ask the king, as simple as that. I would request Pranavish, if you share that link and keep it handy in the group.
Yes.
So that later on we can do a quick exercise. Yes. Okay. Now, yeah, thanks. So we'll come to that.
Chirag, your video is freezed. I guess you are not in a good bandwidth.
Groups which you are a part of, maybe on Facebook and LinkedIn, Quora is an excellent place to build your brand. You have people asking questions about every topic on the earth. A tip when it comes to Quora. Let's say from a digital marketing perspective, I go to Quora, I find a question which is pretty latest and is getting a lot of engagement. Let's say the question is, what are the new trends in search engine optimization for the year 2020? Now, I am getting this idea from a customer or a person who is posting this question on Quora. He himself is telling me what is he looking for. Again, use this idea, answer them. What I would normally do is, I will, let's say if I have a list of 10 things or 10 trends which are there, I'll say, I'll answer those questions. I'll mention 3 to 4 trends in that. And I say, I have written a blog about it, or I have created a video around that. For a more detailed explanation, you can click on the link, and I would probably insert the link of my blog post or my YouTube video and redirect them there. So I'm using this opportunity to not only understand what are the pain points of my customer, I am answering them and I am redirecting them to a place where they'll get more knowledge and more educated about this particular subject, right? And of course, I'm generating traffic, be it for my YouTube channel or be it for my blog post. Okay. Another thing is the survey part of it. Now, I think you have just shared the survey. If every one of you can take a couple of minutes and answer that survey, it's a quick 3 questions. Which are there in the survey. If you could, take a couple of minutes break, I will mute myself. You can quickly go ahead and answer those questions which are there in the survey. And I will then tell you how to use that survey to achieve 3 to 4 different objectives. Okay, guys. So let's, if you guys could move ahead and answer those questions which are there in the survey. Is the link pasted? Pranavesh on the group? Urvi, have you pasted the link? Hello?
Okay, Chirag, team, okay, the link is already pasted in the lockdown series group. Or shall okay. I post this in the same group now?
I think if you could paste it now, that would be easier for them. Great, thanks. In the meantime, what I'll do is I'll open the Google Trends part of it and the Facebook part of it, which I can then quickly show you.
Okay. Guys, somebody is scribbling on their iPhone screen or maybe their computer screen. It is looking real bad. So I would request somebody to stop that doing. Okay, Chirag, you can go ahead and continue.
Okay, just give me 1 second. I'm pausing the share for a second. Just give me 1 second.
Yeah.
So I can see the answers coming in. Now here, let's see what this survey responses gives you the magic of, right? Now, the first question, what is your biggest digital marketing problem? Now, this is being answered by you all. I'm assuming that you are my target audience. So I'm getting a lot of response. Leads is one thing. Content is another thing. Unaware of my audience, optimizing Twitter. I can find that leads is something which is a recurring thing. Okay. First objective being achieved. You are telling me what kind of content you are looking at. Again, I can create a video or a blog post on multiple themes. How to generate leads using Facebook? How can I generate leads using Instagram? What kind of lead generation activities that you can do on LinkedIn? 3 blog posts, 3 videos ready, right? I don't have to do it. In general, how to create a lead funnel? How to generate leads through email campaigns? I am just thinking top of the mind based on what responses that I am getting, okay? Another thing that I can do is here, the second question, what difference would it make to you if I find a solution to the problem mentioned above? Now, you're saying your business improves, 360 degree social media expert, add value, help me sell my product better. So mainly it's about achieving better business, right? So when I'm pitching my services to you, my focus would be how I can help you generate leads and how much of an impact from an ROI perspective it will be on your business, right? So it's also helping me create my entire pitch around the problem that you have told me and the difference it will make onto your life once this problem is solved. Now, how difficult it is. So the answers that are there, somewhat difficult, very difficult, and another was not at all difficult. You are giving me an leads myself. So in sales, there is something called as low hanging fruit. So all the people have said this is very difficult for me is a low hanging fruit for me. They are priority hot leads for me to follow up and connect with them and try and pitch for whatever services might be applicable to them. Somewhat difficult ones are the ones which I can use to engage and build a relationship. If there's someone who is mentioned not at all difficult, then those are the kind of target audience which would be low on my priority, but I'll not ignore them. I'll keep a warm engagement with them. I'll probably send them my email campaigns, request them to follow my social media account, share them case studies, white papers with them around this problem that they have mentioned, which they find it very easy to solve, right? And fourth and the most obvious objective, you guys have shared your email IDs. This is my lead generation tool as well. So each question here in some way is helping me in me creating the content, customizing that content as per my king, which are you guys, and choosing as of now what is top priority for me and connecting with the people which are at the top of my priority list. A simple survey. And let me tell you guys, I have not even put a lot of thought in designing these 3 questions. Okay, so that is what is the power of this one tip that I'm sharing with you. Now, another thing could be going on to the groups, like I said. So I'm instantly going to various groups that I'm part of, and I'll tell you what are the different ways again which you can use to listen what your customer is telling me. Let's say I go to this one of the groups that I'm a part of. I'll search within the group some of the things. I'm just waiting for it to load. Okay. Now, when you go within a group, there is this small section which is search this group, which will allow you to search within the group what conversations are going on. So let's say I'm just looking at a simple query, looking for digital marketing. Let me see what results it gives me. I can further sort it. Let's say I want it to be very latest. So I pick the date to be 2020. Okay. See, here there is someone, if I'm looking for hiring an intern, this is a person that I can connect. Okay. Are you looking for a digital marketing agency for the business? Contact me. I can help you. I can probably look at collaboration with them. Okay. Then there are various things that come up. Also notice the engagement that each of these posts are getting. If you come across a post which has got a lot of engagement, you can probably look at creating a similar post. Also, if let's say, let me change this need digital marketing. See, another way of generating leads for me. We need digital marketers to generate leads for our products. Go here, message them, private message them, and ask them to connect with you. This could be an idea for content. Why you need digital marketing? Okay, need digital marketing team to promote my company. Please WhatsApp. I have got all the details that I need, I require. I can give them a call and start conversing with them. So that's what Facebook groups can do. You now, each one of you would be part of different Facebook groups. Go ahead and do this search. See what kind of results that you get. See which are the most engaging posts which you get there. See if you can repurpose those posts in some way, right? So that is about how you can use Facebook groups. Similarly, you can do a similar exercise on LinkedIn groups, and you can go ahead with that. Now, let me look at Google Trends for that matter. Okay, let me quickly open a new window. Now, when we go to google.com, I'm sure everyone knows this, so this is a very simple thing. Let's say I want to search for let's go first to Google Trends. So this is a service by Google which is absolutely free. Okay, now here again I can do a lot many things. I'll explain you how. So enter a search term or a topic. Let's say work from home is something which is very common, or let's say free online courses is a term that I want to search. Okay, now this is Google Trends. This is slightly different from Google search, but it is powered by Google search. I'll choose a right location, let's say India. Okay, I'll choose a fairly recent thing to explore, let's say past 30 days. You can change this to web search, or you can also change this to YouTube search. Okay, now it basically searches this term in India for the past 30 days, on Google. Now I can see region wise. Now whatever things that you see in breakout, okay, now this is an indication that this search has taken off really well in the past few days, past 30 days, in comparison to the normal search volume that it used to get for this search. Now it is getting more. Now if I am a competitor of Harvard University, I will open this in a tab and I will see what kind of content are they looking at. Okay, sorry, not this. I'll go here and I'll say search on Google. Okay, now this opens. I can easily go there and see what kind of courses which are there, what kind of SEO strategies that do. There are many tools that will help you do an SEO analysis of the competitors. We can probably look at it at a different point of view. Okay, different time. You can see what are the trending topics, how much increase in topics which is there. You can explore them further. You can also compare two different search terms which are there. So that is how Google Trends work. Now going to the normal Google search, okay, let's say free online courses again. So this first part is an ad, but apart from this, people also ask. So one is this auto fill that you are getting, best free, so free online courses and degrees, free online courses with certification. These are all the queries that are doing the rounds, and people are using these queries to find search results for. So this is one way in which you can find what the customer is looking for. Second thing is people who ask also ask these questions. So what is the best free online course? Are there any online courses for free? Another way of generating good content. Third is down here, people also searched for, right? Searches related to free online courses. Another way, if you go on detailed analysis of this, you'll find new ideas for generating content. So this is where you can keep on creating high quality content with the help of these tools, and make sure that your king, which is your customer, is always interested in the kind of content that you are putting across. I hope this point is clear. Now moving on, we have covered all these points. Similarly, you can do a search on YouTube and you will get the answer. Now the third piece of the puzzle, which is the queen. Now only a happy queen will help the kingmaker to keep the king interested. So a happy queen is where you're getting a lot of customer engagement that will help the kingmaker, which is you, the content creator or the content strategist, to keep the king interested. King is your customers. So if you have good customer engagement, that means your king is happy. Your customers are happy. They are engaging with you. The first step is show gratitude. So whenever anyone comments on your post or sends you a response on any of your campaigns, etc., always say a thank you to them. Apart from being having an attitude of gratitude, there is another advantage to it as well, which I'll cover in a second. There is resolve any queries or complaints at the earliest. Now, you will find a lot of people making negative comments if suppose you are offering something and it has gone wrong. Always make sure that you don't ignore those queries or complaints. On digital medium, everything can be tracked. Everything has a footprint. So even if you feel that I have deleted the comment, there are ways in which these complaints could be explored. So never leave a complaint unanswered. Also, if you are able to satisfy the complaint with your answer, it is a great indication that you care about your customer, that you are willing to solve those queries for them, and they will become very loyal towards you. Then the third thing is crucial first hour. Now, crucial first hour is basically how most of the social media platforms work. How it does is when you post something on social media, in the first hour, it shows your content to limited number of people who follow you or are your fans or follow your company. Now, if there is a lot of engagement that happens in that first hour, then let's say, for example, if I take Facebook or LinkedIn, they'll show 5% of your audience the content that you have posted. If there is a lot of engagement, lots of comments, shares, likes, etc., then they will show it to probably more 5% of the people. That is how the algorithm works. So a simple way also is if someone has shared your thing and have mentioned something, if you add a thank you to that, that is another comment, and that also stacks on to the engagement part of it. So apart from being generous and being having that attitude of gratitude, they're also in a way giving an indication to the algorithms of the social media that this is something that you are willing to engage with your customers. Then another thing is queen is one of the reasons the king will listen to the kingmaker. If you don't have customer engagements, right, the king will not listen to you. So make sure you have all the reviews, testimonials, ratings, etc. with you. And remember, always be in charge of making the queen happy. You might outsource everything to your digital marketing agency or in-house digital team, but make sure that you have a keen eye on the queen, that is the customer engagement that is happening. Okay, now the last part, which I'll quickly cover, is planning is essential. So plan well in advance. It's not just about today. Many times what happens is some of my clients, they post daily, or some of the people used to post daily whatever comes to their mind as an inspiration in the morning. Sometimes it could be a good idea, but not always. So make sure you're planned well ahead. Think about what you're going to post today, tomorrow, this week, this month. I'll show you a template which will quickly cover that. Consistency is the key. If you decide that I want to post daily, make sure you post daily. If you decide that I want to post twice or thrice in the week, post twice or thrice in the week. Decide which days you are going to post. Decide and make sure that you never miss on that schedule. Idle mind is the kingmaker's workshop. So it's not the devil's workshop. Whenever you are idle, do this research techniques that I've told you about. Think about different ideas that you can put your content across. Then keep an eye on the queen. Analytics, each social media platform comes with different analytics. Interact with your customers and have a content plan in place. Also, be very flexible. Even if you have a plan and if there is a good idea that comes into your mind, be flexible, execute that idea. Be loyal and go to the customer wherever the customers are there. So I'll give you an example. Nowadays, a lot of people have an apprehension about going to TikTok. But what if your majority of the target audience are youngsters, probably within the age of 15 to 18 or 20. TikTok is one of the mediums where you'll find most of the youngsters being there. Don't hesitate. At least give it a try. That's what I want to share. then always watch out for an attack on the king and the queen. Because if the king leaves, if there are no customers, there is not going to be any customer engagement. As well as if there is no customer engagement, if you are not going to engage with your customers, you are not going to solve their queries, you are not going to resolve their complaints, the customers will go to your competitors. And always keep an eye on what the competitors are doing. Okay. Now, let me quickly show you a template which you can use to track whatever content that you are planning to post. This is again something very simple. Now, these are the dates of posting. A buyer persona, the different buyer personas that we saw in the roadmap template that we said, the different content ideas which are there, status could be posted, approved, draft, or pending, etc. Now, is this topic, the first one, which is how to use LinkedIn to project yourself as a thought leader, a good topic for a blog post? Yes. Can that be tweaked around for an email campaign? Yes. Could it be a Facebook post? Yes. Instagram? Yes. Currently, because I'm more about publishing it, I'm not using it as any paid campaigns. Can I post this link to my article or my YouTube video on WhatsApp? Yes. LinkedIn? Yes. Again, no paid participation there. I can tweet about it probably because I'm talking about LinkedIn. It's a more professional group. TikTok would not be the right platform, but I can surely create a YouTube video around that. What would be the next action step? Probably I'm thinking that I want to create a webinar around how to optimize your LinkedIn profile and what should be the content strategy specifically for LinkedIn. So that's why I started this campaign. My next action date probably would be 30th of April. So create this tracker kind of a thing for every buyer persona and every content related to the buyer persona. Okay, so that will help you be on the top. That will also help you to repurpose a lot of content. So for example, today I use this topic as a blog post. Maybe 15 days down the line, I'll put it as a YouTube video, right? So that reduces your work of thinking new ideas every time, because at some point of time, you might hit a block where you're not able to think any new ideas. So that is one aspect. Another thing that I want to quickly showcase is about the Facebook posts. This is how you can be on top of your competitors. So everyone knows that Facebook gives you insights as one of the things which could be a part of your Facebook page. Now, this is from one of my clients. Thanks. I would like to thank her for allowing me to showcase this data. So now what I've done is in Insights tab on your page, there is a section Pages to Watch. If you scroll down, you can add pages. This could be your competitor pages. Just look at the total number of page likes they have from the last week, what has been the post this week, what kind of engagement they have, and add your page to it. See how do you stand across your competitors. Also, go to their company pages and see what kind of posts that they are posting, what kind of interaction that you have. Also, another thing is all the posts that you are posting, go to the analytics and see which one is getting maximum reach, maximum engagement, etc. Right? Now, this is a travel company. So all you guys know that travel has been hit really hard due to Corona. So that's why the engagement probably could be low at this point of time. But keep an eye. There could be some other reasons. There could be certain posts which could be doing well than the others. So this is in nutshell that I wanted to share. One last thing. If you fail to plan, you'll plan to fail. So make sure that these foundations are there. Make these foundations very strong. And then only on these strong foundations can you build the stronger building of relationships with your customers and the target audience which is there. So now I'll rather shut up and look for my time to listen to my king, which are all of you, and focus on the queen, which is engaging with you guys. So if there are any questions, please feel free to ask.
I would like to keep the king and the queen both.
Yeah, sure. Please go ahead.
Okay. So I will open the room for question and answer. You can go ahead, people. Okay. I guess my first raise hands is Kavita. Kavita, you can go ahead and ask your question.
Hi, Chirag. This is Kavita. I'm Abhichandani from Hyderabad speaking with you.
Hi, Kavita. How are you?
Good, thank you, and I hope the same with you.
Yeah, I am fit and fat as ever. Yeah, tell me. Go ahead, Kavita. Right.
My quick question to you, Chirag, would be that this seems like a 24/7, 365 day thing for anybody to do, because you know it's so much as far as digital marketing is concerned. So how does one do it all? You know, I mean, if I would have been you, are you on your phone or laptop all the time? I really don't know. I want to ask you that.
No, not really. So see, once you have these templates ready, then it becomes pretty easy for you to keep on adding to that. So that's where I said that the basics have to be strong.
Right? I see.
Once you know what your customer is looking at, right?
Okay.
So for example, the survey that I said, you guys filled it up on the moment, and whatever ideas that came to my mind, I was sharing it literally in front of you, making those ideas. Hopefully they were useful. But then because I had that structure in place, I have done this exercise many times, it becomes easier for me at every iteration.
So you're saying it will take practice and structure for us to be able to effectively deal with all our digital marketing needs?
No, not really. Practice, let me be very honest with you, Kavita. If you meet any marketer, forget about digital or non-digital. If they say, I know what works always, then they are wrong. It's always a bit of trial and error. Yes, there could be indicators, there are benchmarks, there are standards, yes. But in some cases it will work, in some cases it will not work. So, and ultimately it's your business. I mean, if you are an entrepreneur or you are a digital marketer, even without me saying, you are most of the times on your business, right? Like I said, if the foundation is in place, then it's a very small iteration. So probably you can take 3 hours from your time on a weekend, create these sheets, and probably whenever you are idle for 10-15 minutes, fill that up. Your content keeps on getting ready every day.
Thanks a ton, Chirag. Thank you so much. It was a wonderful session.
Thanks, Kavita. Appreciate
Thanks, Kavita. Shobhan, you can go ahead.
Yeah, so it was a great session, a lot of insights. I just want to know if we can also have prince and princess, okay, where we are giving information about our products, okay? Can we give also information, supporting information as a knowledge content for our kings? So it will add value. Will it work with digital media?
So see, I'll give you an example and let me know if I've understood correctly. Let's assume Pranavesh is this big shot investor, has crores of money. I keep on calling Pranavesh every time. First time I'll call Pranavesh, Pranavesh, can you lend me 1 crore rupees? He'll say yes. Second day, if I call him again, Pranavesh, can you lend me 1 crore rupees? Reluctantly, because he's a friend, he might say a yes. Third time, mera phone hi uthana band kar dega. So if your social media platform is always selling, 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 it's not going to work. Another example that you would relate to is credit card walo ke call aate hai, personal home loan wale ko call aate hai. Aap mein se kitne log hello sunke bol sakte hai ki ye kisi credit card bechne ke liye ya personal home loan finance ke liye phone aaya, right? So if you're always selling, it's not going to work. So I'm digressing a bit, but what I always tell my clients is I follow a 3E procedure. What I mean that is, first E is education.
Education.
Second E is engagement. And the third thing is earnings. If you educate your clients, you engage with them, the earnings will take care. I hope I have answered your question.
Yes, yes. But how much times we should reach them? Is there a level in which we should reach the customer content-wise? Or it should not be too much also, right?
No. So it depends. If you have customers who are willing to get in, so I'll tell you, let's take an example of Facebook. Okay. Now Facebook, when you put a content on Facebook, if your content is doing really, really well, it will be shown to only 10, maximum 15% of your entire crowd. Otherwise it's hardly 2 or 3%. So for Facebook, a good frequency could be one post per day. It could be more, because you never know which 10% is seeing and which 10% is not seeing. Something like a LinkedIn at this pace, currently LinkedIn's major revenue earning comes from their sales navigator and all those things. They are not earning much from their ad campaigns. Plus LinkedIn ad campaigns are very expensive. They're probably 5 times more expensive than a Facebook or a Instagram or a Google PPC campaigns. Now, in LinkedIn, your organic reach could be probably 800 for a post, which you will put in 1 week. Easily 800 to 1000 people you can reach if the post is doing well, right? That assuming that people are interested in that. So it depends on the platform. It will depend on your business. It will depend on your target audience.
Thank you, sir.
Chirag, I have a question here.
Yeah.
So let's say I'll give you a real time scenario. If I post a content which is related to my personal life, so let's say, for example, I go for a party and I post a party pics or something, I get several comments or maybe hundreds of likes or hundreds of this thing. But when I
post, Pranish, you're breaking up.
Okay, am I audible now? Chirag, am I audible?
This was breaking, so I have not been able to.
Chirag, am I audible now?
Yeah, yeah.
Okay. So, let's say, for example, just give me a minute, Chirag.
Chirag, am I audible? Chirag, am I audible?
Yeah, tell me.
Okay, so what I was asking is, see, when I post a personal picture, like let's say I am...
No, your voice is again gone. I'm sorry.
Okay, let me just...
In fact, it was clearer without the headphones.
Am I audible now?
Yeah, this is better.
Okay. So, I was asking, when I post a party picture or maybe a group selfie of my friends and everything, or my personal DP also, I get several comments and likes on that. But when it comes to business or maybe any post that is related to my LNE Global bolo, yeah, maybe official bolo, yeah, fir kuch learning ka bolo, nobody is damn cared about that post.
Where are you?
Yeah, so there is hardly any likes or comments.
My first question is, where are you posting your personal ones and where are you posting L&D Global related ones?
So now I have stopped posting my personal things.
Nahi yaar, aise mat karo, mere pet pe laat mat maro. Now, on a serious note, see, what happens is that I would always suggest you keep your personal and the professional posts different.
Yeah, because nowadays I have stopped posting my personal pictures and personal things, because I have a clean image of what exactly I do. Because what I've learned from entire social media marketing or digital platform as a grown up, a professional level, what I've done is I've keep my content very consistent throughout my platform. So all my social platform, you can see only professional way. So that is how I built my page. Because obviously, nowadays, it's people go on to Facebook or maybe you can say LinkedIn first when they connect.
Correct.
And that is how you need to build an image there first, your social and digital platform.
So I'll tell you, on LinkedIn, okay, the personal part should be more related to your professional part. What I mean by that is, let's say if there's someone's birthday in your team, putting that is a good practice.
Irrelevant, yeah, correct.
Yeah, otherwise just putting that you have gone to a beach for a stroll, you can put it on LinkedIn, but just imagine, why would a customer care about it?
Absolutely.
Right? Another part, the Facebook part, again, there is a company page there. Treat the company page as your LinkedIn profile. Put everything relevant to your company there. On your personal profile, probably for the queens that follow you, you can put your posts which are of your images or any snaps of any parties that you had gone to.
Okay. Okay. So you mean to say my personal page will be only personal and my official post will be only official post?
That's a good practice to have.
Yeah, I do that. But when I say, let's say I do a professional post on my professional page, and when it comes to reshare on my page, my personal page, will it be allowed or will it look good?
That is okay. That should not be an issue.
No, but then when it comes to my personal page, obviously there are no more audience to be seen on that post. So my question here is, why is that so? So is it that because of the content not suiting with that target audience or something?
Maybe that could be an issue, or it might so happen. I'll tell you another scenario also. The amount of engagement that, let's say, it gets on your Facebook page would be less, then it will like it. It could be your mother likes it. It could be your girlfriend or wife, whomsoever would be there, better half likes it. Uske relatives will like it, but they're not your relevant target audience, right?
When
the focus should be on the reason it's keeping different is because the objectives are different.
Acha. I got it. Take it.
Thanks.
Anybody, any questions? Digital marketing, I hope many people have many questions out here. I couldn't see any questions. Arshuda, Urvi, Neha.
There is someone, Galaxy Tab.
Oh, yeah. Meena ma'am, go ahead, ma'am.
Sorry, I don't know your name, ma'am.
Yeah. You have unmuted me.
Yes,
can
yes, Meena ma'am, go ahead.
Please.
Okay, now for me, you have spoken so much of jargon about technology and digital and all that, you know.
Uh-huh.
But I came on to this, I said, even if I get 10% out of this, maybe I'll get something, you know. Mm-hmm. Now, I do live programs because that's the only thing I know about. I know I can do Zoom and I can do Team also, or maybe Hangouts or something like that. They are very similar to Zoom. But for the time being, I'm doing live. Now, there are two queries that I have. One is, I do have a personal page on Facebook, and I do have the regular ID. Okay? And so, when I do the live, would it be better to do, I have more people on my personal ID than on the page, obviously. So I so far have been doing it on the personal ID, not on my personal page. And then I also sometimes share it on my ID because I want my ID to be circulated also. So is that the right way to do it? Point one. Yes.
So can I answer that first, and probably we can move on to the second question after that?
Yes, please.
Yeah. So my question too is, where is your king?
1 minute. There's an extension to this question.
Sure.
Also, do you think, like people say that YouTube is becoming very popular also. So do you think it is good to do on YouTube and then share the video on personal ID and personal page, or is it good to start off on personal ID on Facebook and then share it on YouTube and whatever your personal page?
Okay, so when you're doing live, okay, my first question is, on your profile or on your ID, which has the maximum number of kings? As in your customers, which of them has the maximum number of customers?
The general Facebook ID.
Then do it from your general Facebook ID. As simple as that. That will give you a better reach.
Acha. Now, in spite of that, my second question.
Meena ma'am, can you hold the second question as of now? I have another guest to ask questions. So I'm allowing only one questions, one participant. I will come back to you for the second question.
Thank you.
Yes.
Don't mind. Let me answer her quickly. It will not take more than 5 seconds.
Okay. Go ahead, Meena ma'am. Sure.
Record everything and post it separately. Post the video separately on Facebook. Post the video separately on LinkedIn. Post it separately on YouTube.
okay, I can share it at all these places.
Don't
right?
share it. Upload it separately on each of your accounts.
But if it is a Facebook Live, how do I post it separately then?
No, record no, download it. That. Download that and post it. I'll tell you a simple reason for that. If there is a guest who comes to your house for dinner, would you take them to your neighbor's place for the dinner? No, right?
Nah.
Similarly, when the video is there on YouTube and you post it on Facebook, as in you just share, why would Facebook like your users to go to YouTube? So upload it separately on each of your accounts.
Okay, I've understood that. Now, I generally, post the introductory JPEG, the ad, one day before. But I have noticed people who do Zoom, they get a lot more people who are coming on to the program. But with these Facebook Lives, I've been doing lives even earlier, but they were general lives because I do my traveling and all. I'm into travel, so I show them places and all that, you know. That is different. But now I've started doing some programs, okay? And I have noticed that even if I put the ad one day before, and I also share the ad on various other groups and all, but there is not much of participation. What do I do?
So there could be many things to that. One is probably the ad is not engaging enough for your audience, or it does not excite them to join. That could be one reason. Second is the content that you are presenting might not be suitable for the king which is there, which is your customers. Probably they are not that much interested. Or probably somewhere down the line, you will have to analyze whether the people that you have in your network are the right kind of audience that wants to go after.
That means I've got to check on the tribe.
Correct.
Okay, fine. Thank you.
Welcome. Thanks, Meena ma'am. KJ, can you come on the line and ask your question, please? KJ? KJ, hang on a minute, okay? Okay,
audible now?
Ask a question. Yeah, go ahead.
Audible now. All right, so Chirag, I currently stay in Pune, and there's a prospect that I met in Pune, and I'm in touch with him. He has a B2B SaaS product.
Hmm.
Okay, so his target audience is the C-suite audience from India and US. That's his target audience.
Hmm.
Only the C-suite audience. So I wanted to give him a proposal. I wanted to know what exactly is the mindset of these kind of C-suite people. Indian and US, and where they are in a digital platform apart from LinkedIn. So what all should I target? If email marketing, then what time is the best? So apart from LinkedIn, what all should I target? Is it email marketing, Facebook?
So see, LinkedIn is the best place to start with. Okay. Second could be email, but I would say use LinkedIn extensively, because LinkedIn gives you a lot of credibility as well. You might have recommendations on your profile. You might have a lot of content on your profile. You might have that featured presentations that LinkedIn allows you to put on your profile. Plus, LinkedIn gives you an opportunity to connect with, so you can know who is the CEO of an XYZ company and connect with them, right? So LinkedIn is a good place. Try to get them to then move on to a demo of the SaaS product, at least. Or a phone call. So try to move them from LinkedIn to a more personal connect, right? So if they are in US and you are in Pune, you'll have to in some way ask them to schedule a demo or a training session or something like that. Another good thing could be, if you are sending them an email, give them a comparative study between your product and the other competitors which are there. You can give them a case study. Let's say if the person using your product is from IT industry, just as a assumption. Give them a case study of another client of yours who might be in IT, and because of using your SaaS product, their return on, see, majority, if it's a CEO, they would be worried about return on investment. If it's a CTO, okay. They would be worried about how it will make their job easy from a technical point of view. These are the two major decision makers when it comes to a SaaS-based IT product, right? And correct me if I'm wrong. So when you are sending an email to a CEO, send them a case study which focuses on ROI aspect. If you are sending an email to a CTO, send them a case study which will give them a comparison with competitors and how your product will help them save their time or do their task in a better way.
Sounds good. Thanks, Chirag.
Thanks.
Okay, thank you, KJ. Anybody wants to ask any question? I don't see any hands raised. Okay, Chirag, people are asking for the PPT and the Excel which you have maintained. I'm sure that you have put a lot of efforts to make that analogy and maybe the Excel things. If you could just share it with us also, it would be more better.
Sure. What I'll do is I'll share it with, I'll see if I can put that in that lockdown group.
Absolutely.
So that
absolutely.
Everyone gets it in one go. Rather than people connecting you and then you sending it across to them.
So sure. What you can do is, you can share it on the lockdown series group itself. People can take it ahead from that.
Great. I'll do that. Probably by today, end of the day, or rather by tomorrow morning, I'll share that.
No problem. Done. Okay, so if anybody is not there on that lockdown series group, you can take this number down and send me a request on WhatsApp. I'll send you the invite link for lockdown series. This is my number. You can always get connected to me on this WhatsApp number. So anybody have a question? Yes, Nirmal, can you go ahead? Yes, I can see your hand raised.
Yeah, Chirag, it was a fabulous session.
Thank you.
A point which I want to clarify with you is that could you share a couple of ideas with regard to privacy and safety while we are doing all this online business, online transactions? A couple of ideas which we should be careful and what are those measures which we should be conscious of?
Exactly from which point of view I didn't get that. Privacy and safety. See, for me, I am a digital marketer or a marketer. For me, if you ask me to share any details about myself, I will be more than glad to share that.
Yeah, but when it
comes to normal safety precautions, don't click on any links which are from untrusted source. Mm-hmm. Like those could be phishing scams. If there are certain things that you are getting from a source that you don't know and you feel it is too good to be true, then be cautious.
Mm-hmm.
Then each social media in the settings part of it allows you to choose what you want to share. So go to the settings part, privacy tab would always be there. You can review that. You can see what you want to share, what you don't want to share.
From your experience, could you suggest us one thing in the settings part which we should really go about? One idea.
So make sure that at least if I am there and if I'm very much worried about the confidentiality aspect of it, make sure your phone number is not there.
Okay.
You can give your email because you can delete it without opening.
Mm-hmm.
If you are on Facebook, there is also, especially for females, there is an option of safeguarding your photo, which is there.
Mm-hmm.
Right. So mm-hmm. you can keep that on so that your photo is not misused in any which ways.
Mm-hmm.
So these could be a couple of things that come to my mind straight away.
Fair enough. Thank you so much.
Okay, we have another question from Archana Shastri. Archana, can you get your question, please?
Hi, Chirag and Pranvesh. Thank you for such a wonderful session. And it was like at the right time when I just started my YouTube channel. And I was just waiting for such kind of a session, and a lot of insights I got from you, Chirag.
Thanks, Archana. Thanks for that.
The only thing that which Meena ji also asked is like, you know, posting YouTube link on the Facebook. So in fact, like, you know, an hour ago I did that. I posted. No worries. But then why, the reason why I posted YouTube link on Facebook or LinkedIn is that I really want to promote my YouTube channel. So, and of course, I really want to spread the videos around. So how I can go with this? Because this is contradicting the idea that I should not post YouTube on Facebook or Facebook link on the other platform.
Okay. So now, one thing is YouTube channel to hai. So that is a good part that you are doing. Second thing is it could as let's say if you are sharing that, there is no harm in sharing directly the YouTube videos because it allows you to embed in multiple platforms. That's how it was done earlier. It's just that recently, as more and more platforms are giving more leverage to videos, they prefer the videos to be there for the simple reason they don't want the user to move away from their platform. Right. So what you can do is you can put the video separately, upload it everywhere. And when you're writing the post around the video, you can give the link to your YouTube channel.
Okay.
So they will, so you can say for similar, so let's say today is a digital marketing thing. I have put a video on Facebook, this webinar, and say if you want to know how you can ace your customer engagement, I have another video which you can click here, which is my YouTube channel link of that video for more details and redirect them there.
Sure. Thank you, Chirag. I will definitely connect you one-to-one if you allow me.
And, sure, Archana ji.
We'll like to go more on this. Thank you very much.
Okay. Chirag, I have a question adding to what Archana's question was. So, sure. I also have a YouTube channel of LLD Global Mumbai called Connect Talks. So, we generally do this posting of videos and stuff. And we have a very, very professional team to do it also. So what we do generally is we post Facebook and apna we YouTube ka post to kar dete hum log. YouTube ka link then we go ahead and post in all the social media post. So do you recommend? So mere ko kya hai basically is I want the right bottleneck to come onto YouTube because all my users has to come to YouTube. So even if I go to Facebook, my audience is on Facebook. So once somebody clicks in, my viewership in YouTube increases, correct?
Yes.
So, do you recommend to keep it that way or do you also recommend to post another separate video, as you said, Meena ma'am, ki separate video upload karo Facebook pe?
See, separate video upload karna abhi logon ne shuru kiya hai bahut. The reason being, the same thing that I said, none of the platform would like you to move away from the platform.
Exactly.
Another thing that you are telling is about embedding. It will include. It will improve the views, like you have said. But still, in either ways, if you want to promote your channel, always include the link of the channel in your post for more videos of relative topics. Another thing that you can do is if you are embedding it on YouTube, on Facebook. For those who are doing YouTube really well, they know that in YouTube there is an editor which allows you to link the different videos which are similar to that. It allows you to create a playlist and then in the end it will show you 4 or 5 related videos.
That's annotation cards, you can say.
Cards, and I'm trying to reduce the jargon there, that's why.
Okay.
So you might get those suggestions, and when you click on those, so make sure that in the end the relevant videos which are there to the video which is in question are always linked to it.
Okay.
That so, could be another thing that you can do.
Also, the first thing is, first question. So, do you also recommend to post it separately on Facebook? And so, although my social media take care of, like, once I post it as an on-air, that, okay, aaj ka ye video gaya YouTube channel pe, my social media teams goes ahead and post it all on social platforms. Wo link post karte hain. So, which generally gets a bottleneck on my YouTube channel itself. But do you also recommend to post it separately on Facebook and Instagram or maybe another platform?
Do either. Otherwise, what you can do is if you want to post it separately, post it after some days.
Okay. So that wo shift bana raha hai YouTube pe at least.
Yes. It could be like, you know, ye hashtag aapne dekha rahega, throwback Thursday.
Haan.
Something like that.
Okay. ठीक है, अंडरस्टूड.
Or let's say if you are interested, you like a lot, you pay me for another video which is there, which will be a paid event. You can say this was the first part of the event that we did, and this is the video of that.
Acha, okay.
Something like that.
Okay, waisa kuch. Okay, sure. Thank you so much. I guess there is one. I have a separate email ID.
Sorry. In Chirag Archana again. Just one short question. आपने अभी कहा throwback Thursday hashtag. So that's what you're saying कि every week Thursday को एक video आप post करते रहिए और उसमें ये डालते रहिए.
नहीं.
Example था अर्चना.
हाँ, I mean I'm just giving taking an example every week pick up week or something like that event और उसको hashtag करते रहिए.
So there are two things here. आप जो बोल रहे हो that is with the consistency part of it, right? Throwback Thursday is the hashtag where people use that hashtag to share the content which is past. मतलब आपके बचपन की पिक्चर होगी शायद.
अच्छा.
So when they post something like that, they use Throwback Thursday as one of the hashtags. It's just a hashtag marketing thing.
अच्छा ठीक है. Okay, got it.
और आप जो बोल रहे हो that is consistent posting on the specific days.
Okay, thank you.
Welcome.
Okay, now Chirag, one more thing. Manish, I saw your hand. Just allow me a question. Okay, Manish, can you go ahead and ask your question?
Yeah, sure.
Can
you hear me?
Yeah. Go ahead.
Yeah, so Chirag, I've recently published a book called Define Your Orbit. And for that, I've been using some social media support. Mm-hmm. So currently, of course, this is a complete social initiative because I've pledged my royalty also to Girl Child Education, Nannikali. And hence, I went with an approach. So though I reached out to few social media groups, I work for Reliance Industries, so I know some good ones. But then all of them were commercial and gave me a very good proposal. But nobody was giving me any commitment of books. So I said, okay, I don't mind spending something. But if there's some kind of a commitment that, okay, with these kind of promotional activities and marketing through social media, at least some kind of an assured or some sense of business. Otherwise, you know, it's just getting views, but no sales. So I couldn't find anyone coming forward. And hence, I didn't go with any social media marketing company, promoting my book. In turn, since it was a social initiative, so I have like team of 2-3 youngsters who are digital marketers in their own startups or organizations supporting me. I've got endorsement from some more than a dozen who's who in this country for the book. Mm-hmm. And I have gone very, slow on promoting those because maximum I'm getting like 5-10,000 views and likes and stuff like that, but the sales is not happening that much. So do you yourself would know somebody who can help me out? I don't mind making it an proper digital marketing paid campaign. So I'm looking for actually a good digital marketer for my whole project, and this is like 3-5 years project because it's not a small idea. It's a unique concept in the world, not just in India or something. What I say, I've got acknowledgement from some who's who, as I said, from the country, and I have huge network outside India. So I want to go in very professional manner, slow and steady, but very solid, because it is a transformational for many youth across the world. So how do you want to take it forward? You know, I'm looking for somebody who's a strong digital marketer to engage as a partner, and then we work as there can be some
retail. So see, Manish,
Chirag, you are freezed.
Surely we can look at it separately.
Have I lost him?
I guess Chirag is out of the room. I will just call him. One second. Wow. Yeah, he is come. Oh. He's come.
Yeah, I think I got disconnected. I'm sorry about that.
Yeah, sure, Chirag. You can go ahead.
Yeah. So, Manish, coming to the first part of it, why majority of the digital marketers don't do a performance-based thing is because the entire cycle is not in their hand. What I mean by that is, for me, to get you a lead is one task which I can control. But to convert that lead is not under my control. Right? Yeah. So that is one aspect that performance-based scenario is not something which is very popular about digital marketers. On the second part of it, if you're looking at the digital marketing engagement, I can probably, we can look at it separately in a separate discussion out of this. Probably you can get my number from Pranavesh and we can have a discussion separately.
Sure. I think Pranavesh would have my number, so you can reach out to me anytime next week.
Sure.
Okay. Yeah, Neha wants to ask a question. She's from my team, Chirag.
Yeah, Neha, please go ahead.
Neha, just give me a minute. Yeah, go ahead, Neha.
Hello, sir. So I had one question. What are the other platforms where we can upload our videos? Actually, I was thinking about starting something new. So what are some other platforms other than YouTube or Facebook where we can get public attention as well?
So Instagram could be one. Again, my first question would be, where are the kings? Where is the customer? What is your target audience? Wherever you find the target audience the maximum, go ahead and post there. If assuming by your looks, I am assuming that you are pretty young. So if your target audience is people who are young like you, TikTok could be a good example. Instagram could be a good example. YouTube is always there, right? So it could be depending upon where the customer is. Welcome. Any other questions?
Okay. We don't have any questions, I guess so. Just give me a minute. Let's allow me a minute. Anybody has a question here? Okay. There's no question, Chirag, as of now.
Okay.
So Chirag, what I was also doing, see, we like our team started this Monday motivation Tuesday, a typical Tuesday, and like every day they post, as you said, right? So they are very, very consistent on their postings. But do you really recommend that we should prepare a calendar to post what exactly goes on every day?
If you can, at least do it on a weekly basis, if not a monthly basis. That's a good idea. Because varna kya hota hai, pata hai Pranavesh? Subhe utke brahma gyan ki prapti hui, banaya kuch aur dal diya. Right?
Achha, so jis din brahma gyan ki prapti nahi hui, to
nahi. Us din sochte baito aur time nikal jayega.
Achha, okay.
So ideally it should be well planned. Plus aisa na ho ki har roz fir you are posting only the same kind of content, because then that bias also comes in there. Iska roz motivation ka hi aata hai aur kuch aata nahi.
So okay.
It should be a healthy mix.
Okay. Sure. So anybody any question? Meena ma'am has a question, I guess. Meena ma'am? Meena ma'am, can you go ahead and ask question?
Yeah, you had spoken about go to Thursday. Now, sorry to say, this is very new to me. Could you shed a little more light on that?
Okay, so Meena ji, it's just a hashtag. Are you familiar with the term of hashtags? How are they used, yes, and etc.?
Yes, I am.
Yo, so there is a hashtag which is known as Throwback Thursday. Now this hashtag is used, throwback, throwback.
Okay.
Now this hashtag is normally used by people who want to post something from their life, be it professional or personal, which is from the past.
Okay.
Okay. So for example, if it's a Children's Day and you want to post your picture when you were small. And okay. Let's assume the Children's Day is on a Thursday.
So then, it has to be a Thursday only or it can be any?
So if you go ahead and search, you will get a Throwback Tuesday also. It's just an example which is more familiar among people who do hashtag marketing. That's why I just used it.
Okay. So you can do Throwback Sunday, for example. You can do Throwback any day.
Yeah, it could be Throwback any day.
As long as you put Throwback and then any day.
Yeah, it's just a indexing kind of a thing for the platform. That's it.
So it is Throwback, and then you could pick up any post of yours or any picture of yours and repost it. Is it? Is that what it talks about?
In essence, yes.
In essence, yes. I'm sorry to say my question may be dumb.
No.
But I mean, for me, technology is... I don't know what to say. Technology, I'm still learning. I'm still a baby in technology. Okay. So
we all were at some point of time.
Yeah. Please excuse me for that. And also you spoke again on YouTube and hashtag and Facebook and LinkedIn and things like that. So why I was wanting to know about YouTube is, even I want to familiarize people with my YouTube channel, because I keep on putting, because there is some information, maybe it's wrong, but I believe that when you do live on Facebook, after 1 year, it gets wiped off. Is that true?
I don't think so that happens, but I'll have to check that. If you have come across an incident like that, then I'll cross check that.
The thing is that if I make a video on my camera, more than 90 seconds, it doesn't go on any place. It doesn't go anywhere.
No, that would be a limitation of the camera. As in your internal settings.
No, I've tried doing it on my iPhone. And I've tried doing it on the Android also. More than 90 seconds, it doesn't.
You can go ahead and check Google Gyani for that. So Google Raja is always there, available for every step by step to do anything. You can check on Google how to do a step to step information on the same.
Okay, fine.
And sir, if not, you can connect Chirag personally on the same.
Sure, I will be happy to help.
Okay. So I have another user, Verma. Verma, can you ask a question, please? Verma, just give me a minute. I'm just unmuting you. Yeah, you can go ahead, Verma.
Can you hear me?
Yes, please.
Great. Chirag, my name is Jeevan Verma. I am a leadership coach and a trainer. And interesting session. I've been listening to this for the last hour or so. One of the challenges that I have with many social media or digital marketing, there are dime a dozen or more, and I've been speaking to them unsuccessfully. The reason is the discussion always boils down and come to this particular aspect of performance-based digital marketing or performance-based deal. And I think you touched upon that briefly for a previous question. And you also mentioned that as a digital marketing person or a consultant, you can get the leads, but you can't help in conversions. And I perfectly understand that. And I give an example, and it's a very funny example. I said, if you're, if I'm a mithai wala and you come across and say, I'm going to, create a big shop for you with a nice facade and do all the decorations and you pay me X amount of money. I can, as a digital expert, I expect you to get in footfalls into my shop. I expect you to get customers into my shop. But if the stuff that I'm selling is not up to the mark, I don't hold you responsible, right? That's my cost. If I'm not able to get the customers to buy any of the products and they walk out, it's fine. But as a digital consultant or an expert in the field, the least I expect is to get the footfalls into the shop. Fair enough. Doesn't go beyond that because almost I think 20 or 30 of the digital consultants, a well-known one that's there in India, in Mumbai also, they back off. They say we can create a great website and they give me gyan. I've been in the industry for 30 plus years, so I kind of get a little pissed off. They give me gyan about SEO and how the conversion happens and you know your audience and blah, 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 blah. I said, I know all those things. It's just that I'm looking at an expert who can do all those things. But in lieu of whatever that we, you know, discuss, they're not able to even get footfalls. So they say we're going to create a mobile friendly and SEO, all the jargons they throw at you. We can do all these activities for you. We can send out mails, you know, landing page and all those kind of stuff. But none of them can guarantee or promise footfalls. So that is a huge challenge for me. Because unless until you can get footfalls, conversion is my responsibility. I can't hold you responsible for that. So to that extent, you know, performance is not your issue. But even to get people into the shop, they can't. Is it because the consultants are not confident about their own abilities, or is there something inherently I'm missing out?
So see, I'll tell you. Verma ji, is it something with respect to SEO that you have faced this specific no, difficulty?
I'm talking about having a digital consultant to position me as a thought leader or to get business as a leadership trainer, change agent, you know, as a thought leader. Generally, the entire thing, you know. I mean, all of us, end of the day, want to have business, right? I mean, conversions and you know, LinkedIn or through LinkedIn to Facebook or whatever it is. So, so digital consultants or so-called digital consultants would give you a paraphernalia of activities that they're willing to do. But it only boils down to activities. That we'll do this, we'll send out 3 mails, we'll send out 5 posts and whatever, whatever, whatever. But nothing beyond that.
So, have they ever shared with you any sort of a strategy or something like what we saw today, the content tracker, what kind of content?
They do all those things. They will send you the trackers and you know what I'm trying to say?
No. So I'm sorry to interrupt. When I say tracker, I'm not just saying ki ye post kiya. There is a lot of discussion that will happen when they are deciding the strategy, and that will happen with you. And if you have a team, then with your team to understand what are your USPs, what kind of content should be posted that will keep you in the limelight as an authority in your field. So there are various other discussions that have to happen around them.
Chirag, point taken. I'm saying that's, to me, that is a second level of discussion. Mm-hmm. The first level of discussion is you and I have to agree on the delivery parameters. If you agree and I agree on delivery in commercial terms, then we go on to the brass tacks of, you know, what is it that you USP? How do we position you? This is what. No, those are the operational issues. But the first level of discussion itself, when I say, can you get me footfalls? Can you get me X number of footfalls in maybe not a week, but 3 months, 4 months, 6 months? They all say, well, we can do activities that we have learned of from colleges and institutes and all those things. We can do multiple activities for you. But beyond that, we can't do anything. So that means I'm throwing money in the air and hoping and praying.
I would just like to speak for myself because I don't know about how others function.
And to be very specific, when I say footfalls, I'm talking about inquiries. You know, in lingo for trainers, these are inquiries from corporates saying that, hey, listen, we saw this. Can you come over for a cup of tea? We'd like to discuss, or what are the things that you get? Those kind of inquiries. That's all I mean by footfall. It's just a metaphor I use.
Yeah, I understand that. So normally I'll just speak for myself. I don't know what kind of interactions you have had previously, but let's say if you are one of the consultants, if you are one of my clients, my first aim would be to understand what is the current status, right? If your current status is like you are hardly getting 10 people in a month, and if you tell me that I want in the next month this 10 to be 10,000, then it's, I know you would not be that unreasonable, but I'm just giving you an example. So then it has to be a mutual agreement. I agree that as a digital marketer, my aim is to get the footfall. right? And it has to be decided based on what the current status is. A better idea for you would be, rather than an absolute number, you can look at the percentage increase, right? So if today it's 100, you can check with them if they are willing to give you an increment of every month by X percentage. Now, as you go higher, the increment will become lesser. What I mean by that is, for once you reach, let's say, 100 to 10,000, right? Whenever, whatever might be the time frame, I would not be able to comment on that before learning about your business in general and what is the exact product or offering that you have. But let's just do a vague mathematical calculation. After 10,000, if you tell them that I want 50% increment, that's not possible on month-on-month basis. Probably after you reach a certain level, and that will again be something which is based on your business and your business model, the increment will keep on increasing. Sometimes it could be just 1%, but if you have a following of 1 million, a 1% is another 1 lakh people that are, 10,000 people that might be added, right? So ideally they should be willing to give you an incremental percentage wise increase in that. That's what my opinion is.
I take your point, Chirag, and I'm not pushing you on this. It's just that I wanted clarity whether am I doing something wrong here, because you'll be surprised to know in our discussion there are no talk about absolute numbers at all from my end. Right? And this is the
conversation. I am sorry to interrupt. There are other participants who are on the waiting thing.
Okay, fine. Thanks.
I am so sorry.
No, absolutely. Thank you. I'll take it offline.
Okay, so I will open the room for open the Lockdown Series group for question and answer with Chirag. You can have a fireside chat there because I have another session to host again. So Chirag, I'm so sorry. You can take it ahead with the Lockdown Series group itself. Anybody who has a question, you can come on to the Lockdown Series group and ask other questions there. So thank you all for being patient so much, and thanks Chirag for being on the platform. And am I visible?
Yes, you are.
Oh, okay. So thank you Chirag for being on my platform. Thank you for the wonderful session and the question and answer that you clarified much with all the patience that you had. And so hope to see you connected again, Chirag.
So, sure, it would be a pleasure to interact with everyone.
Yeah. So LLE Global Mumbai, tomorrow we have a session by Meena Tilakraj on difference between yoga and meditation. So hope Urvi, I am right. No? Okay. So whose session it is tomorrow? Sorry, yeah, go. Urvi, you can go ahead.
Yeah, so tomorrow we have a session by Mitakshara Shirgaonkar critical skills for managers.
Okay, so Mitakshara, we have a session tomorrow. I'm so sorry for the confusion because I get a lot of confusion with it. So tomorrow, be ready, stay tuned. L&D Global Mumbai, collaborate, co-create and contribute. Thank you so much, guys.